No, marry me. So today I want to discuss basically what, let's say, inborn qualities you have, and how I think that we choose these inborn qualities with what lessons or so besides we need to learn in this life. Of course, this is just my theory, it is by no means the end all, by all, anything like that, it is just my thought about this matter. The reason I want to discuss it is that a lot of people feel less than what they should be because they are bad at something, lack a certain quality, or something like that. But I feel that if you lack one quality, you make up for it in another. I'm not saying by that all people are equal, we all have X number like a role-playing character. That if we are extremely intelligent, we might be less strong. I mean, because there are people who are amazing at sport, they're amazing at school, they're amazing at making food, they look amazing, they have all of it. What I am saying is that we are perfect the way our soul shows us to be, for the lessons it wants to learn. And as such, I don't think you should go around and feel bad about something that you are not. Now, of course, there's nothing wrong with working towards it. If you, I mean, if you want to have buff muscles, by all means, work for that. But I think that the way we, let's say, our talents and natural abilities are things that our soul decided that it needed for the lessons learned. And, for example, let me take myself as an example. I'm not a beautiful woman. And of course there are times I wish I were. But, I mean, I have to face reality. I mean, I don't think that I'm ugly like some trolls on the internet likes to say, but I mean, men don't turn when I walk down the street. It is not one of my strongest qualities. I am not particularly beautiful. I am a completely average looking person. However, I'm intelligent. And I value that quality more. And it has been a lot more useful to me in what I do with my life. That I have that intelligence. I'm also very good at understanding abstract concepts. Like, for example, various concepts within the occult. And as such, it is, I think that perhaps that is what my soul decided when it was ready to be born into me. That, okay, perhaps if she is gorgeously beautiful, she will walk another direction in life. And it won't learn the lessons it needs to. And as such, it shows intelligence over beauty. Or take a friend that I grew up with. He was always so sad that you weren't smart. I mean, he was, you know, like real stupid people who are just oblivious. Unlucky for him, he wasn't very smart, but he had self-insight a lot. So he knew you weren't smart. And it bothered him a lot. But I told him, you're kind. You're hardworking. You have a lot of self-insight, you have so many other things. But does it matter that you're not book smart? And I believe that his soul chose this when he was about to be born, that it needed such and such and such. And not just what it's going to learn for positive things, but also what it's going to learn from difficulties. A soul might choose to be born into a poor family because it needs those lessons. Now, one thing that is very important is that even while I do believe that the soul chooses those circumstances, that doesn't mean that A, you can't change them, and B, that you should sort of treat people like shit, because, oh, it's all, they were all born into it, so, oh well. I mean, in some Hindu societies, people treat those that are poor, who are casteless, and so on, very poorly, because they feel that they must have done something bad in their former life to be born poor. I do think that it might be that if somebody is rich and never share their riches, just want more and more and more and more and more, and treat others like shit, they might be born poor their next incarnation, not to punish them, but to teach them how it is to be poor. But I still don't think that makes it right to mistreat people. Because ultimately we have to look at who people are as human beings. Not what money they have, not what they look like, not how book smart they are. But look at them as human beings. And not look at what did their soul mean and want and feel when it was born. Because really we don't know. We can have a lot of theories like the one I present here. But that doesn't mean that we know we have to react to the people, not the theories. But I do think that it can help people accept their shortcomings and work to better them by feeling that there's something more of a reason than just random dumb luck. It has made you who you are. So, I mean, it can be for anything. Some people have an amazing musical talent. I think that their soul chose that because they might need it to something. It doesn't necessarily mean they have to go and become a famous musician. Perhaps there's something else where that music could play a role in the lessons they're about to learn. Somebody is amazingly beautiful, and they need that to become who they are supposed to be. To teach the lessons that they need this lifetime, and so on and so forth. Because I don't believe in fate as a thing that cannot be changed. Like, you have to follow this path because this is the only path that you gotta follow, blah 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 blah. I don't believe in that. I do believe that there are some sort of I don't believe there's a fate that you have to follow, but I do believe that there are sort of guidelines laid out for your life. And think of it like this: if you a road. You don't have to follow the road. You can go into the forest and go everywhere you want to. But there's a road that sort of indicates where you should go. Perhaps just road signs. And I believe that your natural abilities and so on are a part of those road signs. It's the same that I do believe that everything happened for a reason. But I don't believe that you have to be a slave to it. It's like this. Let's say that something gets in the way of a relationship all the time. And you say that, but it's not meant to be. Perhaps it isn't meant to be, but you have free will. So you can say, fuck this, I'm pursuing a relationship anyway. There's nothing wrong with that. So I think that those various old signs are just guides for you. You don't have to be a slave to them. But I do believe that feeling that whatever things that you were born with are gifts from your spirit for whatever things that you need to be able to handle in your life for the lessons needed can make you feel better about yourself, make you feel more that whatever difficulties you have, whatever gifts you have, whatever talents you have, are there for a greater purpose than just random dumb luck. Like, Sophie is randomly very beautiful, very book smart, but not very physically strong. And Robert over here, he is very book smart, he is great with the violin, but he doesn't look too good. So I'm feeling that instead of it being completely random, it is whatever lessons you need to learn. Because I believe that when a soul is ready to be born, it can see so much more. Now, like I said, I don't believe that you have a fate that you cannot diverge from, because I believe you have free will. At the same time, I do believe that soul before it is born can see the future. However, I don't believe that the future is set in stone. What you do, what others around you do, can change this outcome. Look at it about like, if you read the science fiction series Dune, the futures there are not set in stone as such. You have free will, you can make another choice here, another choice there, but for example, space and guild navigators, they can see just a sea of various kinds of future, various possible futures. I think the soul is a bit like that. It can see what possible futures are and can then choose things to maximize the chance that you'll learn what you need to do in the life you are headed towards. So by that, I believe that you should celebrate your shortcomings because they are learning tools for your soul. You should celebrate the gifts you have, what talents you have, because they are also learning tools for your soul. But of course, if there's a shortcoming you want to remove, by all means do so. Perhaps removing that shortcoming is the lesson. Because if we just sit and double guess ourselves constantly, I have a problem, I'm not very good at math. So I probably shouldn't learn it because perhaps my soul don't want it to be. No, you can't sit and think like that. Just do what you want to do. Do what you have to do. Because for all you know, that learning process of overcoming that shortcoming is what your soul wants to learn. But what I'm just saying is that I do believe that it's not random. I believe that there's some rhyme and reason to why you are what you are, and I do believe that while we are not all equal, it's not like we have a equal pot of points to share around. I do believe that every human being have qualities, abilities, and talents that makes them unique and good and wonderful in their own regard. Even if some might be better at one thing or another thing, and some might be better at a lot of things, and one person might be just good at one thing. Everything has something unique to add and to offer. And I believe that all of this, both your shortcomings and your gifts, are divine. So yeah, that's just some thoughts about that. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I would love some discussion about this, so if you have anything to add, just post it down there. So yeah, have a great day. God bless you.